I stood up and said, I will not, I want to make a manifestation, and I will interpret later on if I want to make a question. So,
well, Mr. President, may I just remind the gentleman on the floor, the Senate President, the status. I gave a privileged speech, and when the person gives a privileged speech, he has a floor. And when someone asks to interpolate, he is borrowing the time and needs to follow, and the time is the person giving the speech. So I am giving him the floor now. I'm just making sure that there are no others who want to speak, and I will already sit down and give him the floor. But while the one giving the speech is in the podium and on the floor and has not sit down, he still is the floor. But not to delay this and to give the gentleman all opportunity to explain. I will give him the floor. I just ask that we stick to the issue, Mr. President.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Minority Floor Leader. Mr. President, I would like to, first of all, apologize for the fracas that happened. It was not intended. I was just trying to answer certain personal assaults against my person, but I will not deal with those matters anymore. Let it stay in the record, and let the divine spirit determine whose truth is the correct, where lies the truth. I have served this country for almost 50 years. I've been subjected to all kinds of investigations, and in fact, I was imprisoned twice by two lady presidents, but I will leave that aside. I was simply taken by the very hard assault on my person, but I will not deal with that. I would like to deal with the problem of at hand, which is actually the heart of the issue. And that is the budget of the Senate. First of all, Mr. President, I would like to say that I have no objection to any independent body that will investigate this Senate. Not only the office of the Senate President, but the entire Senate. Because I believe that the Senate is a single office headed by the Senate President. Although it's divided by committees, nonetheless, the contemplation of the Constitution, as I have read it, is that whenever there is a need to do so, may I have some water, please? The head of the office, like the president, the chief of the Supreme Court, speaker of the House, as well as the Senate, president of the Senate, can augment, did not say realign, but augment the budgets of other offices within the ambit of each of that department. And this has been a long practice being done, not only now, but ever since the Republic was started. And so I will deal with the issue at hand. Now, Mr. President, the issue, if I understood the gentleman from Taguig, was the almost 600 pesos MOOE of the Secretariat. I would like to state, Mr. President, for the sake of the public, that the budget of the Senate for 2012 is 2,853,000,000. And this is broken down into six parts. The first part is 1,294,000,000 for personal services. The second part is denominated Senators MOOE, and this amounts to 430 billion pesos. This MOOE, by the way, Mr. President, covers the MOOE of any budget allotted to a senator, simply as a senator, like Senator Arroyo, which will also cover his needs for personal services, MOOE, or capital outlay, depending upon his needs. And then the rest of the 430 billion would be allocated to the budget, or to the MOOE, rather, this is MOOE, of the various committees. But every senator, given a committee, no matter how many, is only entitled to one budget for a committee. The third item in the included in this 2,853,000,000 total budget of the Senate for 2012 is Senator's capital outlay, which is about 4 million pesos. And then the fourth is the MOOE of the Secretariat, which amounts to 589 billion pesos. I think this is what the gentleman from Taguig rounded, the 600 million pesos. And then the fifth item of this budget of the Senate is Capital Outlay Secretariat, amounting to 390 million pesos. And the balance, after adding all those that I've already mentioned, from the 2,853,000,000 covers the requirements of oversight committees. And this amount is 494 million pesos. These are outside the ambit of the authority of the Senate President, other than when he is requested, if I remember correctly, the practice to approve any realignment of amounts saved from this particular portion of the budget. Now, with respect to the MOOE of the Secretariat, or the 600 million pesos mentioned by the gentleman from Taguig, which according to him must be accounted for, I'd like to read into the records the total items covered by this. The exact amount of the MOOE of the Secretariat is 589,685,000 pesos. Number one, traveling expenses, 189,675,000 pesos. This covers travel to local and foreign places. Rete for Secretariat rank and file and offices. Number two, training expenses, 7,726,000 pesos. This deals with training conventions and seminars, slash workshops, etc. Number three, office supplies expenses amounting to 35,277,000 pesos. This deals with expenses for office supplies such as ball pens, copy papers, IT supplies. Number four, gasoline and oil, $14,518,000. And this covers expenses for gasoline, spare parts, and lubricants. And then number six, utility expenses amounting to $51,474,000. And this covers expenses for power and water consumption. The number seven, communication expenses, $6 million, covering postage and delivery, telephone, landline, mobile, and internet. Then number eight, membership dues and contributions, $1,947,000, covers membership dues, contribution fee to professional and recognized organizations. Item number nine, advertising expenses, $816,000, cost of advertisement in newspapers, magazines, television, radio, and other forms of media. Number 10, printing and binding expenses, $3,292,000, expenses for the printing, binding of manuscripts, documents, records, journal of the Senate. Number 11, rent expenses, $124,999. It covers rents, and lease of contract for building offices, parking, and lot copying machines. Number 12, representation expenses, $38,401,000. Expenses for official meetings and or conferences and committee hearings and rate for officials. And then 13, other professional services, $48,692,000. Covering expenses includes for consultancy services, legal services, auditing services, contract services like janitorial and security, and other services. And then number 14, transportation and delivery expenses, $482,000. Cost of transporting government inventory, property, and equipment. Number 15, subscription expenses, $4,420,000, cost of subscription to newspaper, magazine, library, and other reading materials. Number 18, repair and maintenance, $9,362,000. Repairs to building, furniture and fixture, motor vehicles, IT equipment, and software and other property. Number 17, extraordinary expenses, $47,593,000. Expenses incidental to the performance of official functions such as meetings, conferences, public relations, etc., rate for officials. And lastly, taxes, duties, and fees, $1,905,000. Expenses includes taxes, duties, licenses, and fees due to regulatory agencies. Total, $589,685,000. Sir President, this is what is in our budget, and these are all covered by the GAA, and I just have them copied or Xerox, and I'm presenting them for the record. Now, as far as auditing all of these expenses and so forth and so on, I'm open to it. I support it. Of course, this is not my decision alone. It has to be decided by the Senate as a body. because this involves the interest of the other senators, not only the Senate president. And the decision in this will have to be done by the collectivity that is the Senate itself. Now coming to the money that supposedly I gave as a Christmas gift to the members of the Senate. This was given evenly to everybody, including the minority. This was not my money. It was not cash that I gave to the members of the Senate, to the senators. If you will see the check that I used, it was a land bank check drawn against a government deposit account, which is in the name of the Senate, and my office as a Senate president, and that checkbook is an official checkbook for that particular deposit account of the this government office, and I issued that money, that I issued the check to the individual senators, to their names. And they know that this is a public fund, and how they will treat it, I suppose they're well-meaning, loyal, knowledgeable gentlemen and ladies. They must know that this is money of the people that must be used for a public purpose. I do not have to tell them or educate them about it. When I say it was a gift, it was simply because during our last session, I think, the Senator Rangara and Senator Drilon heeded me here on the floor, and I think the minority floor leader also. And they said, as usual, even in the past, we have had this practice that during Christmas time, the head of the office takes out from his available savings something that will augment the resources of the senators, because it's Christmas time, there are many pressures on them for this, for that. Some people would like to have pasalubong or anything like that, depending upon their needs. And precisely to show that you can trace, the auditor can change the source of this money, whether it came from my own personal pocket or from the pocket of the one government office inside the Senate and transferred to another pocket of a government office inside the Senate, would be traced through the check that I issued, which is in effect a receipt and an evidence of the movement of this fund to whomsoever it came from and to whomsoever it was sent and given and received. Now, I own the responsibility for all of this. The written orders I issued, I assumed the responsibility for that. I issued them. But I think as a head of the office, I have a right, and I was given a power to change those orders when, in my judgment, there was a need for it. I instructed my chief of staff, who happens to be the administrative officer who handles my office, because I cannot read very well. I am suffering from macular degeneration, and he does these things for me. I told her that given the fact that the members of the minority have their own savings from their own budget as senators and as committee chairman and as chairman of oversight committees, and I saw the request for realignment, I thought that I have to exercise my discretion to give them 850,000 each, and I gave a bigger amount to the members of the majority. I must seek your indulgence on this because this is a practice that I have known since the birth of the Senate in 1940. The members of the minority were never given any chairmanship of any committee. If you are a minority, you are simply a minority. You are not entitled to any privilege. And I was treated that way when I was elected in 1987. In fact, my office was a dilapidated cubicle near a toilet, and I never complained. And I was never given any special budget or any bonus or anything. Now, this was also the practice of the Senate until the President Fernand, what's the name of? Marcelo Fernand became the Senate President. He started the practice of giving chairmanship to the minority. Now, the original practice still exists today. Even in the House of Representatives, if you are not a member of the majority, you are not entitled to a chairmanship of a committee. You are not entitled to any special privilege. I've been a member of the House from 1992 to 1995, and I was a member of the minority, and I never received any special gift to anybody. Now, I would like to, I thought that I must differentiate, and maybe that was my fault, differentiate between the majority and the minority by just giving the minority a lesser amount than what I have given to the members of the majority. But if that was the basis of resentment, well, I assume the responsibility for it. Now, the gentleman from Taguig, I think, knows that this was the practice even during the time when he was the chairman of the Committee on Accounts. And I remember at that time, if ever there was any extra amount to be given to us, it was given to us in cash. Even the commission on appointments. When I was a member, all of a sudden I was given, at the end of the year, a certain amount of cash, but I did not use cash to give to the members of the Senate precisely because I want the people to know through the Commission on Audit where the money came from, how it was disbursed, and how it moved into the accounts of the Senate so that the auditor will know through the movement of that check and the books where it entered, where the money went, its source and its end. Now, I'm saying this without blaming anybody. The practice of giving MOOE to members of the Senate is not my invention. The liquidation system being used in the Senate was not invented by me. I inherited it. It was done by previous presidents. It was done by previous senators. I followed it in 2008 when I became a Senate president. Nobody complained when I gave additional MOOE to all the members of the Senate in December of 2008. I think I also gave them checks, what they call now a Christmas cash gift. I gave them the same thing in 2009. Nobody complained. I gave the same thing in 2010. Nobody complained. In 2011, I also gave the same thing, and in increasing amounts, nobody complained that there was something anomalous or unconstitutional about these things. It was only now that it happened, simply because I made the mistake of differentiating between the majority and the minority. Maybe if I did not do that differentiation, and there would have been no hullabaloo about this whole thing. But I own the fault that I made the differentiation, and I stand by that decision. I have a reason of my own, which I will not disclose, but I stand by it. And so that's my explanation. Thank you, Mr. President.
Majority Leader.
Thank you. Mr. President, Senator Langara, the Chairman of the Committee on Education, Arts and Culture, will sponsor 90 House measures, all pertaining to...
Can you say that again?
90, Mr. President, yes. All pertaining to...
Senator Juan Ponce Enrile there, delivering about the, maybe about a 20-minute response to Senator Cayetano's privileged speech earlier this afternoon. First of all, he apologized for what he called the fracas between himself and Senator Cayetano. He also discussed the Senate budget and defended his decisions in terms of distributing that budget. He said that this distribution system was not his invention, that he inherited this system and he followed it, and previous Senate presidents have done it. He also said he's open to an audit, even if the Senate has to make that decision. He also said that the dispute may have arisen because he made what he said was the decision to differentiate between the majority and the minority, and that may have resulted in this dispute between himself and Senator Cayetano. Again, Senator Juan Ponce Enrile apologizing for the earlier fracas between what he called a fracas between himself and Senator Cayetano, and then explaining the budget system of the Senate and how he said the distribution of the MOOE was a previous practice that he just adopted. This has been an ANC Live coverage. I'm Kwakwa Alkwas. We now return to regular programming.